Bro, an exclusive clip of chapter 5 is here. I haven't checked this out yet.
What's that sound?
I know I should have put my face on it, but you can just hear my voice alone. What is happening? No. Is this? No. What is it? Oh, breezes! The breezes are back! Oh my goodness. I didn't think they would bring the breezes back.
Pleasure to meet you. I'm
Mrs.
Hip Petals of Zephyr Heights.
Oh my god! Woo! They even got the gibberish talk. Nah.
These two say they haven't seen other ponies for a long time.
You know breezy language too?
It's our pony language, but
they haven't been. Oh my god. So yeah, they haven't been around in a long time.
Yeah.
Oh my god, yes. Bring it on. September the 18th. September the 18th. We got the breezes back. And I'm so happy to say yes.
What is up, everypony? It is me, Elusive Owl, here, and welcome to another installment episode of My Little Pony Make Your Mark. Yes. So this is chapter 5, episode 2, following from what we've seen for the first episode, which was the Cutie Blossom Bash. And I did say at the ending of that episode for the first one that that for Misty, she's going to be that she's going to be a double agent, going both with Opaline and her friends, and that's what she's doing as of now. But I also want to think about the Bridalwood episodes that we're going to get to, that the breezes might touch upon for her. And luckily, the description might help me out here, because the description for episode 2, and episode is called Family Trees Part 1. So there is going to be two parts to this, so I will do separate videos of them on different times. But for part one, it says, is Misty having bad dreams or visions of the future? The group heads to Bridalwood to see if the wishing tree can offer any clues. Okay, so this might be regarding to visions on how the future with her friends or with Opaline is going to turn out. Like Opaline, like she could have bad dreams about Opaline turning her down, you know, like, and completely erases her cutie mark. And then there's the thought that she could lose her friends again, just like what happened in the finale of chapter 4 of episode 7. Yeah, those kinds of possibilities that could affect her in a mental state. So, yeah. Anyways, but the main talking point for this is the Breezies. The Breezies are back. Yes. The Breezies make their debut in Generation 5. So excited for them to, because we've seen what they are like, and from that little preview clip that's leading up to this episode, and it's pretty good. It's pretty good. You know, exciting times. But yeah, I think I'm not going to like ramble on any further. I think we're just gonna jump straight into this episode, and we'll see what happens from there. This is two parts. For family trees, and this is part one. I will do part two for another day, but as of now, let's react to part one of the two-parter episode. So this is chapter 5, episode 2, called Family Trees, the first part. And let's get this started in 3, 2, 1. Here we go. So that was chapter 5, episode 2, and I think that key in the end has the power to unlock the past on Misty. Once she uses that key, she will know about the past. Fully on her past, where she belonged, what's happened to her family, and how did she end up with Opaline at the castle? How did she end up with her? What did Opaline do? What did Opaline do to her parents? Like, questions. There's questions that needs to be answered. Oh. But at the end there, where Alpha Biddle's cutie mark was glowing, and you saw all the shadows of Misty's memories and backstories that you see, and the visions of a dream that she had as she got startled as she woke up. The shadow figure looked like a resemblance of Alpha Biddle. That could be Misty's father. That could be Misty's father. Oh my goodness. I can't scream very loud. As I mentioned on the reaction, it is quite late here. But, I mean, it has to be Alpha Biddle. It has to, hasn't it? Just from the way the figure looked and everything. But yeah, I have to feel though for Misty, because those backstories that we looked at. She did grow up in Bridalwood, because we can see from most of the visions that she was revolved around Bridalwood, and then some pony was pushing her on the swings. Could be Alpha Biddle that was doing that, and then you see all the mist like clearing up and everything, and then Bridalwood was gone from that point, and that led to the Breezies' return. Oh yes, and the Breezies, when they made their entrance, and the suspension of music for when it was building up for when the Breezies made their appearance, like the lights from the flower when they all blossomed and just lit up, it looked really nice. They had no idea what's going on. And then Izzy was like, no, we haven't seen them in a long time, and Zip was getting ready to defend her friends. They're like, what's happening? What's going on? And then as they pop out, Breezies! The Breezies are back, and they've made their debut in Generation 5. And yes, and they have a night market inside of the wishing tree, and it looks really, really nice as well. Like, it makes me think about like how much crafting, like, have they used? Like, I know the breezes have been around for generations and generations and generations, you know, but surely it must take a lot of time for them to like use their craft to like put inside different markets, or if they might have more than one market for them. But I think their only market now is the night market inside of that tree. So, yeah, I mean, it could be. That could be the solution. So, yeah. Also, Sparky being like gravely weak in this episode. Like, you can tell that dragon was not fully himself within this episode. He wasn't fully himself for this one. So they've tried using different things to revive him, to try and be himself, you know. Like, they've tried using like a crystal, they've tried using like different potions or whatnot. Like, I mean, they could work out. I mean, there's got to be something in Bridalwood that can spark up Sparky, you know, after having the dragon fire within him taken out, because of what Opaline did. There's got to be like some sort of remedy to get Sparky back to his normal self, you know. Bridalwood might have the solution to it on the market with the breezes, and that's what we might see in the second installment for Family Trees. So that was basically part one of Family Trees, and part two is where it's going to be really exciting, really, really exciting. Like, we've talked about Sparky, but mainly on Misty's story. Bridalwood, did she grow up on Bridalwood? The shadowy figures that we've seen on her flashbacks, was the shadowy figure that she saw, did it look like Alpha Biddle, or did it look like some pony else? I want to believe that it could be Alpha Biddle. Alpha Biddle's cutie mark was glowing. It was glowing as he was in the tree, and Misty was in the tree as well. So, yeah. So his cutie mark just happened to glow right after Misty got the key, and that was the key that one of the breezes gave her, and that tree can unlock, and it has to be unlocked within that tree from when she saw it. So she has to unlock it so that she can gather the past, you know, like gather everything from what she's gone through. And what I want to know is who her parents are. Where did she grow up? I mean, it's got to be in Bridalwood. And what did Opaline do to take Misty to her? Because she cannot remember. And I've got a feeling that Opaline may have something to do with the cause of losing Misty's memory. And I don't know what she did entirely to make her lose the memory, but she did something to make her lose that memory and forget about her parents and forget about where she lived. And that made Opaline's story change. Like, how she said that, like, she brought her within, like an orphanage or something like that. But that's not entirely true. I don't think that's entirely true. Like, I think within these two parts, we could be seeing now from where she was actually brought up in that heritage. Oh boy. So yeah, if it is, brilliant. But as of now, Everypony, that is going to do it for the first of the two parts of Family Trees. And this has been Chapter 5, Episode 2 of Family Trees, Part 1. And if you've enjoyed my reaction to this episode, then make sure to hit the like button down below. And if you're new to my channel and want to check out more of my videos, then you can hit the subscribe button and hit the notification bell for more updating content when I upload my next video. Don't forget to check out all of my social medias. They'll be down below in the description. You can check all of my... did I say socials? I think I said socials. Yeah. Oh yeah, you can check out the video reaction down below in the description as well to this episode. I'll leave that down. And leave your comments on what you thought about this episode. Did you enjoy it? Did you not? What are you excited for part two? And what did you enjoy particularly about this episode? But yeah, let me know everything you want to know down in the comments below. And with all that being said, Everypony, thank you very much for watching. And I will see you all for part two of Family Trees. Bye for now, Everypony. The door. Get to the door already. And just get to the point where Alpha Biddle is the father of Misty and Opaline. What did you do? What the hell did you do? What did you do to Misty?